We hear a lot about self-esteem. We even hear talk about the self-esteem movement, which is basically this idea that there's an entire generation of people, probably millennials if people are naming a generation, because if you have an opinion on the internet and you want to complain, you should complain about millennials, even if you are a millennial, apparently. Anyway, the self-esteem movement is supposed to be this idea that people were raised being given trophies for trivial things, just for even just participating, and therefore they suffer from an overly inflated sense of self-worth, a kind of narcissistic personality disorder. And I don't know, these kinds of generalizations about generations are basically always untrue. But even if we took it on an individual basis, these people seem pretty rare in my experience. It's not that they don't exist. Certainly there are the Donald Trumps of the world who seem to genuinely believe that they are the best thing since sliced bread. But it's my observation that there's a lot more people who share my experience, which is that the voices in my head, the inner monologue I have going, is not very kind as regards its opinions of me. So, we are told, for example, that regarding our appearance and our worth to society, that the only opinion that matters is ourself, right? We shouldn't depend on outside affirmation for determining our own sense of self-worth. The problem with that is that it's not a very kind opinion. It's a pretty cruel opinion of myself when it gets right down to it. And this makes it actually hard to hear that outside affirmation when it comes. It is a gorgeous day here in Portland. Recently on Facebook, I conducted an experiment. I put up an image that said one like equals one compliment, and I promised people that if they liked that post, I would respond to them with a personalized, sincere compliment. This was an experiment I wanted to see, first of all, just, you know, whether people would feel free to actually like the post, whether they would maybe feel too self-conscious about actively requesting a compliment from me. Also, whether or not I would be capable of taking the time to find something personalized and sincere to say about every person. This turned out to be easier than I expected. As it happens, there are a lot of really cool people in my life who I already harbor very good feelings towards, and so I could generally just write down what I actually feel, and it worked out as a compliment pretty well. Where the challenge came in is not necessarily in finding something complimentary to say, but in finding something to say that the person in question receiving the compliment would actually be able to take on board. Something which wasn't just a nice thought that I had in my head, but something which might be the words that they needed to hear at that moment. Now, I don't presume to be able to read people's minds across the medium of Facebook, so I'm not saying I was always successful in delivering the right compliment at the right time. I'm sure that there were people who read what I wrote and just said, "Taps, he doesn't mean it," or "Bah, he doesn't know what he's talking about," or whatever. I imagine that there are people who reacted this way because I know full well that people have given me compliments in the past, and that's how I've reacted when I've heard them. In fact, it's precisely because I'm aware that we have these barriers against the receiving of compliments that made me put some thought into how I would deliver the compliments, hoping to try and find a way to subvert those barriers, to get around them, maybe even surprise the person so that they would find themselves taking the compliment seriously for once. To do that effectively, I think you have to take into account several things. One, avoid cliches when you're giving someone a compliment. A kid who's been told 100 times that he's smart, or a woman who's been told 1,000,000 times that she's pretty, is gonna have really high barriers, really high defenses against hearing that same compliment repeated again. Two, you gotta go deeper. Not only is a compliment like "you're smart" cliche, but it's just too superficial. There are 1,000,000 kinds of smart. What kind of smart in particular is the person that you're talking about? Which means that in order to go deeper like that, you have to be an observer of the people around you. You have to pay attention, you have to listen to them, and you have to notice what is true about them, what distinguishes them from other people. And I think the third thing that comes into this is that you have to be someone who they believe. You have to be someone who has demonstrated sincerity and honesty in the past with them, which means that it's hard to give someone a compliment if your constant attitude and behavior toward people around you is one of snark and sarcasm, which is ironic as well as a little bit tragic, because a lot of sarcasm is actually a kind of self-defense mechanism that we're using to protect ourselves from the suspicion that if we were actually sincere around other people around us, they wouldn't like us. In other words, sarcasm is something we use to defend ourselves our self-esteem, and yet by so doing, we cut ourselves off from sincere relationships with other people. And that sincerity in those relationships can actually be the basis for building up a strong and healthy sense of self-worth. I guess what it comes to for me is a lot of times we tell people who are having a hard time loving themselves that they just need to have a stronger internal sense of self-worth, which is a lot like telling people who are poor that they just need to pull themselves up by their own bootstraps, or telling people who are depressed or anxious that they just need to stop being depressed or anxious, or telling people who are addicted that, you know, it's all about willpower, that they just need to quit whatever behavior it is that they're addicted to. In fact, we tend to denigrate any kind of reliance on outside affirmation as being attention-seeking or codependent, as if every single person should be some kind of island of pure, unshakable confidence, but I don't know anybody who is like that. Maybe for today you're not capable of just loving yourself and being content with that. Maybe you're not capable of saying to yourself, I'm beautiful, and believing it and letting that be enough. Maybe it doesn't hurt sometimes to have an outside voice say to you that you're clever, that you're witty, that you're creative, that you add value and meaning to this life for me and for others. And maybe I can be that voice from you from time to time, and you can take my word for it when the internal voices are lying to you and telling you that you're a worthless piece of shit. And maybe from time to time you can be that voice for me, and maybe mutual love and self-giving is more dependable and more life-giving than self-love alone. Maybe for just a few minutes we can silence those inner critics and be buoyed up by the excellent companions we have on this journey. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and if you really like this video, then go out, find someone who needs one, and give them a sincere, personalized compliment today.